Wouldn't it be nice to have several thought leaders in your industry know and love your brand? Start a podcast. Invite your industry's thought leaders to be guests on your show and start reaping the benefits of having a network full of industry influencers. Learn more at sweetfishmedia.com.
You're listening to B2B Growth, a daily podcast for B2B leaders. We've interviewed names you've probably heard before, like Gary Vaynerchuk and Simon Sinek, but you've probably never heard from the majority of our guests. That's because the bulk of our interviews aren't with professional speakers and authors. Most of our guests are in the trenches leading sales and marketing teams. They're implementing strategy. They're experimenting with tactics. They're building the fastest growing B2B companies in the world. My name is James Carberry. I'm the founder of Sweetfish Media, a podcast agency for B2B brands, and I'm also one of the co-hosts of this show. When we're not interviewing sales and marketing leaders, you'll hear stories from behind the scenes of our own business. We'll share the ups and downs of our journey as we attempt to take over the world. Just kidding. Well, maybe. Let's get into the show.
Hey everybody, Drew McLellan here from Agency Management Institute, bringing you another episode of the Agency Track on the B2B Growth show. Super excited to be back with you again. Many thanks to the B2B Growth team for inviting me to do this. And really grateful to all of you for reaching out and giving me your thoughts about the episodes to date. For asking questions based on those episodes, and also for your suggestions and questions about future episode topics. So I'm super grateful for that interaction and invite you to reach out to me at any time. Super easy to find on LinkedIn. My email is just drew@agencymanagementinstitute.com. So happy to chat with you in any of those channels. In this week's episode, I want to talk a little bit about how agency owners should be spending their time. And I can tell you that I have come to this insight and this best practice from a couple different avenues. So as many of you know, I own Agency Management Institute, and we work with about 250 agencies and agency owners a year. We see them in workshops, we work with them in coaching and on-site consulting, and where we see most of them is in our peer groups. So we have these agency owner peer groups that sort of work like a Vistage group or an EO group. Only everyone around the table owns an agency, and we have virtual versions of those. Those guys meet monthly, and then we have live versions where the agency owners travel to a destination or a location and hang out for 2.5 days with each other, either in the spring or the fall. Well, actually, they do it both spring and fall. So twice a year they're together. But anyway, not only do I get to hang out with all those agency owners and help them fashion their best week, but I'm also an agency owner. So I've owned my own shop for almost 25 years. And knock on wood, it seems to be going fine. So I spend about 20% of my time on the agency side of my life today and about 80% of my time on the AMI side. But there was a long time when all I was doing was running my agency, and I followed this model. And I do believe that following this model is what allowed me to be able to step away from the day-to-day work of the agency. And today, it's why I can spend as much time as I do on the AMI side. So most agency owners grew up in the agency business. So probably 1 out of 10 agency owners are business people who decided they wanted to own a business and happened to either start or purchase an agency. That's the rarity. Most of us, 9/10 of us, and I am certainly in this camp, we grew up in agencies. That's where we sort of cut our teeth professionally. We worked for other people. And at some point in time, either we decided that we were going to leave wherever we were at and start our own shop, or maybe we got downsized, or we got ticked off at a boss. Whatever the impetus was, all of a sudden we were hanging up a shingle. And then next thing we knew, we were looking around going, oh crap, I'm running a business. I was a copywriter a year ago, or I was an art director, or I was an account service person. And now all of a sudden I'm a business owner. And for many agency owners, that's a hard transition. We are so used to doing the work. We're so used to being very client facing, or at least on the deliverable side of the business. And I think that part of that is we feel valuable there. A, most of us, because we've been doing it for a while, are pretty good at it. So we're able to do it efficiently and effectively and pretty quickly. So from the agency's point of view, we're a great investment because we can really, an agency can get a lot of ROI on an agency owner doing client work. The problem is that if you, the agency owner, are doing client work, then no one is doing agency owner work. There is work that is unique to us, and no one else in our shop can really do it at the level that we must do it for our agency to be successful and sustainable. And so I think one of the maturation points for an agency owner is when we finally have the courage to step away from what is now easy for us and that we're super good at and start doing the things that are harder for us to do and maybe is something that we have to grow into before we really feel confident in our skill levels there. And that's really the sign of a mature agency owner, that somebody's really ready to grow their business. So I want to walk you through how an agency owner should spend their time. And I acknowledge that I'm going to talk like every agency owner can do this every week. And I know that for all of you, stuff is going to happen. There's going to be fires. There's going to be client emergencies. But the trick is to set up your week and your deliverables and your expectations so that your team knows what they can count on you for, so you know what your job is and what you need to deliver. And if that means you also have to jump into a client fire or whatever, that's fine. But these other things don't come off your plate. So understand that what we're going to talk about in this episode are things that only you can do. And they have to be done if your agency is going to be around in the next 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. So the first one is, and the most important one is biz dev. Now, you may not be the primary salesperson. You may be one of the few agencies who has found a salesperson who actually can sell more than their salary. I will tell you that that's a rare breed of salesperson in agency life. In most agencies, the number one salesperson, the most effective salesperson, in terms of not only landing the sale, but landing the sale with clients that are right fits for your agency, they're going to stick around, is the agency owner. So for most of you, about half of your week should be spent on biz dev. And that doesn't necessarily mean cold calling or, you know, trolling networking events. It can be working a list. It can be having coffee with referral sources. It can be lots of different things. And for each of you, based on your agency, who you serve, the services you sell, your biz dev activities are going to be different. But in most cases, the agency owner has to drive that. I'm not suggesting that you have to do it all by yourself. I think it's a good idea to build a small team within the agency and sort of have multiple people working on the deliverables against that biz dev program. And that might be your content strategy. It might be your PR strategy to get your agency's name out there. I'm not saying you have to do it all, but you do have to champion it. And you do have to play a key role. And at a certain point in the sales process, you have to step in and close the sale. Again, you might have one of those unicorn salespeople, but for most people listening to this podcast, you have tried it and it has not worked multiple times. And that's because I know you don't want to be the salesperson, but there is nobody better suited to do it than you. So the lion's share of your week, 50% on average, should be spent in some biz development activity, whether it's list building to target, decide who you're going to target, whether it is working on mailings to those people, whether it's showing up at a trade show where you know your prospects are going to be. It's a wide variety of activity that you need to lead. And in some cases, you actually have to be the one doing the work. So I'm going to pause for a second before I tell you the other things, the other parts of your week. And I'm going to say this. I think one of the most effective and smart strategies for agency owners is that you spend at least one day of the week not in the office. I'm not saying you're not working that day, but you were working someplace else than the office. And here's why. Because a lot of what I'm going to tell you is part of your ideal week requires a fair amount of concentration and quiet. And there is nothing about you being in the office that is going to invite or evoke quiet and concentration time. You know what happens. The minute you walk in the door, people are following after you to get to your office because they have something to talk to you about. And your office doors typically a revolving door of activity. And if you get 15 minutes uninterrupted, that's a great day. Well, you know what? You can't do your agency owner activity in 15-minute increments. You're going to need bigger blocks of time where you are uninterrupted. So I love it when an agency owner will carve out one day a week and work somewhere else. Some of you can work from home. Some of you, that's impossible to do because either your house is as crazy activity-wise as your agency, or you're just too easily distracted. So go to a public library and rent one of their conference rooms. Go to a Starbucks and put on headphones. I don't care where you work. I have one agency owner who has a cabin that's about an hour away, and he goes up there and works at the cabin. I don't care where you go, but don't go to the office, right? Because that's the most productive day you'll have. If you can't carve out an entire day, if you believe that your agency cannot survive without your presence for a full 8 hours, which you and I should talk about that offline, but then do 2 half days. And by the way, do not do 2 afternoons, because you know the minute you get in the office, all hell breaks loose and your day is shot. So I want, if you're going to carve out 2 half days, make them 2 mornings. So you don't go into the office until your half day of work is done. All right. So again, 50% biz dev, carve one day a week where you are not working in the office. And by the way, that means your phone is off. You're not checking email. Like, you have to really unplug. So you're giving yourself 4 hours if you're doing the 2 half days, or 8 hours of really focused time. Yes, you can check your email and voicemail every few hours in case there's a real fire. But I'm hoping that what we're going to talk about in this episode will help you build an agency that is not that dependent on you every minute of every day. Because if it is, it's not scalable and it's probably not sustainable, and it can't be that much fun for you. So our goal is to get it to be more sustainable, more scalable, and certainly more enjoyable for you. So 50% of your time on biz dev activities, whatever that may mean, and you're going to carve out a day, 8 hours a week, however you want to do that, to work anywhere but at the office. The next big block of time that I want you to spend your time on is team development. This is everything from doing reviews, doing one-on-ones with the leadership team or whoever reports directly to you. It's about conducting some lunch and learns or teaching your team. One of the things we hear from agency employees every time we're with them, and we're with them a lot, is that they want to learn more from the agency owner. They have great respect for what you've done and what you've built, and they want to learn from you. So 20 to 25% of your week should be spent on team development. And that is, again, a mix of one-on-one meetings. It might be, if it's review time, it might be reviews. It might be just some individual coaching that you're working with some specific employees around a skill set, or maybe somebody just needs some extra support because of a client challenge, whatever it is. But it's you spending time mentoring and building and supporting and growing and educating your team. And again, that's going to be a plethora of activities. It's going to vary from week to week. So you got 50% biz dev, you've got 20 to 25% team building, and then the last big chunk of time is actually running the agency, so working on the business. And so I'm going to break that activity, so again, that's going to be another 20 to 25%. I'm going to break that activity into sort of 3 big buckets. And the 3 big buckets are, you are going to be overseeing the financial health of your agency. So you're going to be looking at dashboards every week that give you some clarity into how the business is doing, whether it's cash flow reports or billing and utilization reports, or how you're getting to your AGI goals for the month or the quarter or the year. You're going to have a plethora of things on a dashboard, and every one of you should be building out this dashboard with your bookkeeper or your CFO. What are the data points that you need to be tracking to know that your agency is financially healthy? And a lot of those should give you very much, everything's good, it's a green light, or uh-oh, we're in a little bit of trouble, a yellow light, or oh crap, something is really broken, we need to stop, we need to figure it out, we need to make some decisions, we have some red light activity. And the dashboard should give it to you in that very simple sort of, at a glance, you should be able to tell how the agency is doing financially and if you need to step in and do anything. So that's part one of running the agency. Part two is one of the things that your agency desperately needs is a vision. They need a vision of this future state of where the agency is going. Why are we doing this? What are we working towards? And this is a combination of vision and team building. For each person on your team, they need to understand what their role is in that future state of the agency. So what is the agency working towards? Where are we headed? And what is my role in helping us get there? And what will my role be like when we get there? So you need to create this vision, and it's around mission and vision and values. And I could go on and on about all of those. That's a podcast in and of itself. It's critically important, and too few agencies invest the time to really think through and be thoughtful about their mission, vision, and values. And even fewer, even the agencies that have done that hard work, which is not a lot of you, most of you, if you've done that, it sits in an employee handbook somewhere, and maybe you talk about it during orientation, but after that, no one ever talks about it again. No one ever sees it. No one ever hears it. And a great agency, an agency that retains clients, an agency that retains employees, is an agency that celebrates and talks about their mission and vision and values all the time. And you've got them displayed on the wall, and you have them baked into employee reviews, and you have peer recognition around the values. All of those things happen in well-run agencies, and it's your job to set the mission, vision, and values because it's your company. And so they have to be something that is really comfortable for you to put on and wear every single day. They are born out of you. Yes, you can sort of make it a committee process if you want to, but honestly, the mission, vision, and values have got to be in alignment with your personal mission and vision and values because you own the joint. And then the last part of running the business is what I call client love. And this is time spent with clients, not on projects, not on work. This is sort of leader to leader time. So it's you taking the CEO or the CMO or the business owner out to lunch or out to the golf course or to a ball game or to a play or whatever it is that they love to do. But it's you spending time with your clients in a social setting, not in a, we're in a conference room working setting, but in a social setting where you can also talk to them about how things are going. Are we exceeding your expectations? How's my team doing? What's going on in the business? Tell me more about what the goals are and what you're trying to accomplish. This is about you having a conversation with a business owner or leader that probably no one else in your organization can have because you are a business owner and leader. So it really is peer-to-peer conversation about business goals and all of that. And I will tell you, this is also the time when you should be expressing your gratitude to that client for the opportunity to partner with them. This is the time for you to be talking to them about your vision and where you're taking the agency and how you believe that aligns with where they're taking their company and how you guys can be great partners as you each march towards your goals. So these are kind of lofty conversations. And yeah, you're going to get a little granular. How are we doing? Are we hitting deadlines? Are we hitting budgets? Those sorts of things. But I bet you 90% of the time, the other thing that happens is somewhere in that conversation, the client goes, oh, you know what? We're working on this thing, or we're launching in a new city, or we're doing something. Your conversation is going to trigger this. We've got something coming down the road that actually I hadn't thought about it, but we need your help on this. So it is not meant to be a biz dev effort, but oftentimes it will turn out to be. So if you spend 50% of your time on biz dev, and let's say 20% of your time on team development, and 20% of your time on running the business, that still leaves you about 10% of the time. And that's going to be the time you need to put out the client fires. When there's an all hands on deck yell because a project deadline got missed and everybody's got to pull together to get it done, whatever it may be. Those sort of client emergencies that happen pretty much every week in an agency where they need your expertise, where they need that super efficient and effective and fast delivery. And maybe you need to be a part of that, but you shouldn't be doing client work all the time. And you shouldn't be the day-to-day contact person for your clients. Now, I will caveat all of this. It's really difficult for an agency owner to get out of the day-to-day work until your business is, you know, 6, 8, 10 people. When you're an agency of 5 or less, odds are you're doing a lot of client work. So this may be aspirational for you. This may be the next step for you as you add either FTEs or more contract labor to get you out of the day-to-day. But for most of you, this is how you should be spending your time now. And I know for most of you, this is not how you're spending your time. So I'm also not suggesting that you wipe your calendar clean and start doing this 100% starting next week. But start carving out the time. So the first step of this is start blocking time off on your calendar to work anywhere but at the office. When you have that time, whether it's an hour next week or 2 hours next week, and then you maybe you increase it to 3 or 4 hours, hopefully within a month or two, you can get to the full 8 hours. But whether it's an hour or 8 hours, in that time, only do one of these three tasks. Only do biz dev, team development, or working on the business. Don't spend it working on clients as you're carving that time out and slowly evolving your role to be more about what an agency owner and only an agency owner can do, and less about the day-to-day work that hopefully your team can do and you can start stepping away from. And I'll tell you what I think you're going to see is, I think you're going to see an agency that runs a little more smoothly, where people have a better sense of where we're headed. So it's sort of like driving without your headlights on and all of a sudden turning the headlights on and you're like, oh, I can actually see down the road. Okay, I know where we're going. And the other thing I think you're going to see, and you're going to love it, is that your team is much more capable than you give them credit for. So when you start stepping away from the day-to-day, they're going to fill in the gaps. They are going to step up and step into your day-to-day role so that you can do the agency owner stuff that really is uniquely yours to do. So give them a chance to shine. Give them a chance to stretch and to grow and to show you what they're capable of. And you show them what you're capable of. Show them how you can run the ship, how you can be a great leader and spend a lot of time bringing new opportunities into the door so that everybody can grow and prosper, that you are very invested in your team and you want them to get better at their craft. You want them to be able to grow in their profession and you're there as a support to help them do that. And that you're the one who's watching the agency. You are overseeing it. You're making sure financially you guys are in good shape. You are making sure that everybody knows where we're headed and why we're headed there and how everyone is going to contribute to that. And you're spending time loving on the clients and letting them know how much you appreciate them and value them and making sure that you get sort of that early warning signal if something's going wrong. That's how an agency owner should spend their week. And I hope you can evolve to that slowly. But in 60 days, you could be doing all of those things that right now, either somebody's sort of doing or you're doing on, you know, at night and on the weekends when you can, or in many cases, just aren't being done the way they should be at all. Invest in your agency, invest in yourself, trust in yourself, and trust in your team. I think this is all super doable, and I think you're going to be really happy with the results. I hope you give it a try. All right, I will be back with another episode on the agency track on the B2B Growth Podcast before you know it. In the meantime, if you're interested in what AMI's got going on, our workshops, our coaching, we have some on-demand courses, we have live workshops, those peer groups I mentioned, head over to agencymanagementinstitute.com and check it out. We also produce a weekly podcast called Build a Better Agency, where sometimes I'm talking just like I'm talking to you guys, just you and me talking. But in most cases, I'm interviewing subject matter experts who will help you grow and build and scale your agency to be exactly what you want it to be. So swing on over and check out the podcast, if you will. I'd love to hear from you. And I'll be back soon. Thanks.
We totally get it. We publish a ton of content on this podcast, and it can be a lot to keep up with. That's why we've started the B2B Growth Big 3, a no-fluff email that boils down our three biggest takeaways from an entire week of episodes. Sign up today at sweetfishmedia.com/big3. That's sweetfishmedia.com/big3.